This week, we're getting coached up by the head athletic trainer for the football team, Phil Hedrick. And Phil, you know, when you think about a football player, a lot of people tend to think that it's just trainers or guys taking these guys off the football field. There's so much more to what you guys do for the football players.
Correct, Mark. I mean, we're here, you know, from sun up to sundown with these guys. Obviously, there is a lot that goes into keeping this team healthy and on the field. And me and my staff, it's our responsibility to oversee the total health care of our players.
People tend to think ice, you know, recovery, but there was a lot that you guys bring to the table as far as maintenance, making sure a guy's prepared to play the game on Saturday.
Correct. Obviously, prevention is the best cure that we have, but, you know, unfortunately, some guys aren't so lucky and they do have these injuries that do take place that cause them to miss, you know, a small amount or a significant amount of time away from the game. So obviously what we try to do in conjunction with our strength and conditioning staff is try to prepare our guys to be physically fit before they get on the field to help prevent the injuries from happening in the first place.
Now what we're going to do is you get me ready to play the game of football. You ready?
Correct. Ready. Well, Mark, obviously one of the things that we see a significant amount of in athletics is soft tissue injuries, especially related to the hamstring. So what we like to do is get our guys in here. We like to get the circulation going, get a good blood flow going to the muscle group before we even stretch the muscle out. So what I have here is this, we just call it a stick. It's a rolling stick. We're gonna put it on your hamstring. We're gonna roll your hamstring out. We're gonna work on some of the knots and adhesions that we're gonna feel in your muscle that could be limiting some of the range of motion that you have prior to beginning the stretch.
There is still some muscle in there, Phil.
There is a little bit, and obviously, you know, being the specimen that you are fairly knotty here. I'm sure that you're just living such a healthy lifestyle these days.
Absolutely. There's a lot of work that was standing on the sidelines preparing for these football games.
Right. What we're going to do now is just show you a basic movement pattern that we do a lot of times in our rehab process. Obviously, football is a sport where power must be generated. You must have flexibility throughout all of your joints. So this particular movement pattern is going to help really isolate not only the lower body, but it's also going to concentrate on your back and your shoulder mobility as well. So I want you to raise your hands up, raise them up high, okay? Now I want you to hinge at the waist, go down and put your hands on the platform, okay? I want you to perform a squat, okay? Now I want you to raise your right arm up. I want you to raise your left arm up. Now I want you to press into the floor and come up.
Really
basic movement.
Feel that, yeah.
But you really see, you can feel it in different parts of your body. And obviously as we rehab guys, this movement pattern is very important to help regain the mobility that's going to allow them to put on the strength that they need to get back on the field. All right, Mark, we're going to put you in our HydroWorks underwater treadmill just to do some sport specific conditioning, you know, in the pools. You know, I see a look of apprehension on your face, so I guess I need to ask this first, as I ask most of our guys where I put them in here, is can you swim?
Yeah.
Okay, now that we know that you can swim, I'm going to lower you down to approximately chest level. This pool goes down to a depth of 6 feet, so don't worry, you're going to be okay. However, I will warn you, it does go up to a speed of 8.5 miles per hour, so we're going to see how fit you are here momentarily. Obviously, this is what we're doing with them as we want to transition them from what we're doing in the training room, from their strength phase, getting back into the sport-specific phase. So we get them back in here, we reintroduce them to the running and the functional movements that they have to do on the field. So obviously, in football, running straight ahead is imperative for performance. However, lateral movement is also another key ingredient that our guys have to do and do well on the field. So what we have them do, if you just turn to your right, we're just going to do a lateral shuffle. Also have them do the karaoke. And as guys progress, we turn them back to the front. We change the depth of the water to help, you know, challenge how much body weight they're having on a specific joint. One of the final things we like to do with the guys, we have them scoot towards the back of the treadmill. Now we're going to see how athletic you are, Mark. We're going to speed it up. We're going to have you sprint up and touch the front. Obviously with this is a good tool that we have to work on range of motion, but it's also a good tool to work on strength, not only the lower body, but total body. This is a good total body conditioning tool that we have here in the Murphy Center. After our guys have successfully completed what we'd like for them to do in here, and obviously this helps us with diversity of training for our guys during their rehab, we then transition them to the ground doing sport-specific exercises and transition them back to our strength and conditioning coaches.